Today we're going to be making our own clay coil pot. We're going to start with a ball of clay, a little cup of water, some toothpicks, and a popsicle stick. I'm going to start by taking a chunk of my clay and creating the base of my coil pot. I want to roll it into a nice ball and then flatten it to make a nice flat pancake-like circle. Now I don't want it to be too big, probably about the size of a fist or a soda can would be a really good size to work with. Once I've got my circle done, I'm going to take a toothpick and I'm going to write my name in the bottom. I want to do this before I start building so that way it's easier to get it on there. I'm going to set my bottom base kind of to the side, and then I'm going to start with my extra clay and I'm going to start rolling my coils and any balls or spheres I want to make and add to my coil pot, or maybe spirals or squares. There's a lot of different ways you can create different types of coils to add to your coil pot. I'm going to get all of these made and then I'm going to start attaching them. I can kind of measure my coil against the base to see how long it needs to be. This way I'm not making really, really, really long coils and having to make them shorter while I'm trying to attach them. I also want to do a row or two of spheres. So instead of adding a coil, I'm going to add a row of spheres. Now when I make my spheres, I want to make them about the same thickness as the coils I'm making, so that way they're not way larger than the coils are. I want to make them as close to the same thickness as possible. Now for your coils, you want to make them probably about the size of your pinky finger or just a little bit smaller. If you make them too thin, then they're going to end up cracking and breaking a little easier. So you got to think about the thickness of your coils and your little spheres as well. Once I've got all my coils and my spheres, and even I can do a row of spirals if I wanted to, I can start attaching them to my base. Now that I have my coils made and I've got my base made, I'm going to start attaching my coils and start building up my coil pot. I'm going to take my toothpick and I'm going to rough up the very edge. It's my scoring technique, and I'm going to rough up my coil as well. This is our scoring or scratching technique that's going to help our clay kind of bind together a little stronger than just sticking it on there and not doing anything. It's going to help make sure that we don't have clay falling off. If my coil is a little too long, I can just cut it off and then kind of meld it together. Now, whenever I attach two pieces of clay, I need to score and slip. So rough up where it's gonna attach with a toothpick and then add a little bit of water. I'm gonna do this on both sides. It's gonna make it act kind of like Velcro when I attach my pieces. So add a little water, and then I'm going to attach my next row. You want to make sure as you're building your rows, you're stacking on top and not on the side of your rows. Because if you do on the side, then your coil pot is going to end up building out instead of up. So keep building while scratching and attaching every piece that you attach. You want to do that even if you're doing the spheres or the spirals as well. Every single piece of clay that gets attached to another piece has to be scored and slipped, so that way it does not come unattached. I'm gonna keep building, and I think the next row I'm gonna do is a sphere. So I can go and build a row of spheres, and you got it, attach every piece by scoring and slipping. Thank you. I keep building and building my coil pot up until we either run out of time and it's time to clean up, or you run out of clay. The more you build it up, the taller your coil pot is gonna be. I decided that I'm gonna keep a few of my extra clay pieces and just recycle them and use them for a different project. So I'm gonna stop building like it is right now because I like the height that it is. I'm gonna go and I'm gonna kind of double check everything, make sure everything is lined up the right way. I can smooth out any cracks that I see, and then we're gonna let it dry. Once it's dry, we'll come back and we will paint our coil pots with some watercolors. You can paint them however you want. And what's nice about painting with watercolors is that they dry really quickly and the colors are nice and vibrant. I'm excited to see your coil pots and get started with you guys.